Hello and welcome to 3D Nato. My name is Renato, and in today's video I'll show you how to model this object in Blender following a technical draw. This is the tech draw for today's video. Let's check the top view. The first thing I like to do is to set a reference for the X and Y axis. Here I'll use these two crosses and this dashed line. The crosses will be the X axis center, and the dashed line will be the Y axis center. Meaning the intersection between them will be zero on both axes. The next thing I like to do is to break the drawing into basic shapes. And for the main outline, I can see that we have 5 circles with the 15mm radius. These two quarter circles here that are 20mm to the left of the x-axis center and are 20mm apart from each other, which will give us 10mm above and below the y-axis center. These two semicircles here that are aligned with the x-axis center and are 80mm apart from each other, which will give us 40mm above and below the y-axis center. And this semicircle here, that is 70mm to the right of the x-axis center and aligned with the y-axis. Inside these shapes, I can see that we have another 8 circles. These two 7.5mm radius semicircles, these three 20mm diameter circles, and these three 10mm diameter circles. And as this is a symmetric object, I only need to model the bottom part. Let's start sketching. The first thing I like to do is to delete everything in the scene and set units length to millimeters. Press A to select all objects in the scene and X to delete. And on scene, go to units and set length to millimeters. Let's start creating a circle. Press numpad 7 to go to top view, shift plus A to add, go to mesh and select circle. Expand the Add Circle menu, set vertices to 64 and radius to 15mm. To zoom on a circle, press numpad dot. Let's make two copies of this circle. Press Shift plus D to duplicate and enter to confirm. Press Shift plus D to duplicate and enter to confirm. Now let's move them into place. Press G to grab, X to lock axis, type minus 20 to move it minus 20mm and enter to confirm. Press G to grab, Y to lock axis, type minus 10, and enter to confirm. Select another circle, press G to grab, Y to lock axis, type minus 40, and enter to confirm. Select another circle, press G to grab, X to lock axis, type 70, and enter to confirm. Now we need to create another 5 circles to create the holes. One with a 7.5mm radius, two with 20mm diameter, and another two with a 10mm diameter. Select the left circle, press Shift plus D to duplicate, enter to confirm, and to show the sidebar, and set the size to 15mm. Select the bottom circle, press Shift plus D to duplicate, enter to confirm, and set the size to 20mm. Press Shift plus D to duplicate, enter to confirm, and set the size to 10mm. Select the right circle, press Shift plus D to duplicate, enter to confirm, and set the size to 20mm. Press Shift plus D to duplicate, enter to confirm, and set the size to 10mm. Notice this will mess with the object scale value, and we need to reset it to 1. To do this, press A to select all, Ctrl plus A to apply, and select scale. To make all circles part of the same mesh, press Ctrl plus J to join them. Now go to Object, set Origin, and select Origin to 3D Cursor. Press Tab to go to Edit Mode. Select these 8 vertices here, press Ctrl plus plus sign 15 times to select more, X to delete, and select Vertices. To finish the outline, enable Snap and set it to Vertex. Select these 3 vertices, press E to extrude, Y to lock axis, drag the mouse cursor to this vertex, and left click to confirm. Select this vertex, press E to extrude, Y to lock axis, drag the mouse cursor to this vertex, and left click to confirm. Shift select this vertex, and press F to create a new edge. Select this vertex, press E to extrude, Y to lock axis, drag the mouse cursor to this vertex, and left click to confirm. Shift select this vertex, and press F to create a new edge. Select this vertex, press E to extrude, Y to lock axis, drag the mouse cursor to this vertex, and left click to confirm. In this part here, instead of connecting all vertices following a flow, I'll create the least amount of faces I can, meaning I'll not worry too much about creating quads, at least for now. I'll start on these two semicircles to the right. Select these two edge loops and press F to create a new face. Select these two edge loops and press F to create a new face. Select all these vertices here and press F to create a new face. Now these two circles. Select half of both circles and press F to create a new face. Select the other half of both circles and press F to create a new face. Select these two edge loops and press F to create a new face. Select all these vertices here and press F to create a new face. Now this shape to the left. Select these two edge loops and press F to create a new face. Select all these vertices here and press F to create a new face. The base mesh is almost complete. We just need to add a mirror modifier. Press Tab to exit edit mode, go to modifiers, add modifier, generate, add a mirror modifier, set it to y-axis, enable clipping, and set merge value to 0.1 mm. When clipping is enabled, it prevents the extrusion from creating faces inside the mesh. Let's check the section view. We can see that this object's height is 20 mm. We can also see that from the bottom to the end of the first hole, we have 10 mm. And from this to the top, we have another 10 mm. Let's finish this mesh. Before we do this, let's check something first. Go to Viewport Overlays and enable Face Orientation. If the faces are showing in red, it means they are the inside part of the mesh. To fix this, press Tab to go to Edit Mode, H to select all, and Shift plus N to recalculate normals. If they are still red, just check this inside checkbox. With all faces selected, press E to extrude, type 10 to move them 10 mm, and enter to confirm. With Shift plus Alt, remove these two small circle edge loops from selection. Press E to extrude, type 10, and enter to confirm. Press Tab to exit edit mode, apply the mirror modifier, right mouse, and select Shade Auto Smooth. The object is complete. As this is a hard surface object, and I don't plan to add a subdivision modifier, we don't need to worry about all those non-quad faces. But if you want to subdivide, and maybe even add a bevel modifier, let me show you this free add-on. It is called QRemeshify, and I'll leave a link in the video description for this add-on. To show you what's happening, let me enable wireframe. After the add-on is installed, it will be here on the sidebar. Notice this add-on creates a remeshed copy of the mesh, so if anything goes wrong, you can go back to the original one. This add-on had a lot of features, but I'll focus primarily on these two, symmetry and density. If you enable symmetry, the add-on will remesh only half of the mesh and will add a mirror modifier. And the density represents the poly count of the mesh. A lower number will result in a higher definition, and a higher number will result in a lower definition. Just to demonstrate, let's see some examples. Here with a density of 3, now with a density of 2, and now with a density of 1 with symmetry on the y-axis. Now if you want, you can add a subdivision modifier or a bevel modifier without creating weird faces. And there you have it, another TechDraw model in Blender. If you're still here, it means you are liking the content of this channel. I really want to thank you for spending your time with me learning some basic Blender. I hope you have enjoyed as much as I have making it. So please, consider subscribing to the channel, like the video, share it, and leave a comment. Thanks a lot for watching, and see you on the next one. Bye bye.